Hello guys, Tom Quayle here for Guitar Interactive Magazine, back with another review. And this time, I've got this. This is the newest Dave Mustaine signature guitar from Dean. And it's called the VMNT Holy Grail guitar. And as you can see, it's quite an impressive looking thing. Very unusual. This guitar actually sports a whole complement of 24 karat gold leaf embedded into the top, which is very impressive indeed. Impressive price tag as well, obviously, because of that gold leaf. But as usual, let's have a look at the guitar, starting up at the headstock end and work our way down. Now, this is a true USA through and through thoroughbred Dean guitar, built in the custom shop. Now, to celebrate 33 years of Megadeth, there's only 33 of these produced. And looking up at the headstock, I'm gonna show you something fairly special in a second. We start with this non-more metal, all black design, properly kind of spiky Dean headstock with six per side tuners. Then we've got the Dean logo on there. And then we've got the Mustaine signature. So we've got Dave Mustaine, the signature actually, scrawled across there as well, which is very nice. And if we turn it over, here's the cool bit. So I'm gonna, sorry for the cameraman, but this is a very long guitar. Made in the USA. And then we've got, that's the Dave Mustaine, obviously, or the, you know, you can see him playing the guitar there. And then we've got one out of 33. So this is the original prototype guitar. It's exactly the same as the other 33, obviously, apart from the arrangement of the gold leaf, but this is the first, so that's super cool. Okay, so turning back over, we've got an ebony fretboard, again, metal as you can get, with these medium frets, okay? Now, considering they're medium frets, out of the factory, this thing's got a slammed low action and there's no buzzing anywhere. So you can play super fast on these medium frets. You don't need jumbos for this guitar. So if you're worrying about that, don't, it's not a problem. And then we've got Dave Mustaine's custom D-shaped profile neck, which is a mahogany neck. And if I turn it over again, quite an awkward guitar to handle, obviously, because of the flying V-shape. It's finished in this gloss black paint on the back, and then we've got the gloss finish on the back, which is very, very smooth actually. It's not sticky at all, but obviously lends a kind of visual quality that you don't get with a satin finish. Okay, as we move up, you can see we've got this set neck design with the flying V. It's a mahogany body and a mahogany top. Now, unlike a lot of flying Vs, as we come through here, you can see we've got a contour on the back, so it's a little bit more comfortable. But before we move too much this way, let's just turn it over, and you can see we've got 24 frets, and we've got these custom Dave Mustaine inlays as well, which were designed with Dave's preferences in mind. Now, as we move into the actual body here, you can see we start to get this blood red base finish on this mahogany top with this 24 karat gold leaf. Now, this is real, proper gold leaf. This is not some kind of effect they've got on here. It is the real deal. Now, obviously, that makes the price skyrocket because there is a fair amount of gold on this top. And this is inspired, apparently, by Dave's trip to Jerusalem, where he looked at some old antiquities, some ancient antiquities, and he was looking at various different kind of ancient artifacts and came up with the idea for this guitar. The guitar actually comes with a very large custom hard case, which is extremely well made. You get a certificate of authenticity, and some may be into this, some maybe not, but it also comes with a chalice, apparently. We don't have one with the guitar here to show you because this is just the guitar that's been sent for review. An engraved chalice that kind of celebrates this 33 years of Megadeth and represents Dave's trip to see these ancient antiquities, which is kind of cool if you're a Dave Mustaine fan. You know, it's a nice thing to have with the guitar. Makes it more collectible as well. This is obviously a collector's instrument with only 33 made. We are not reviewing this guitar thinking that the average guy is going to rush out and buy one of these. You can see we've got a Tone Pros Tunematic bridge, and then we've got the tailpiece here, which is obviously the V shape as well. These are custom Seymour Duncan live wire. I'll just make sure I get this right. Live wire gold. Okay, now these are active. There's a battery compartment on the back. So they're very, very high output, very, very clean, clear sounding pickups. And then we've got, now this confused me at first. We've got a three-way switch. Okay, you can hear the separate volumes coming in there because you could hear the guitar start to activate. And then we've got two volume controls, one for each pickup. Now, I thought they were going to be wired, and I'm assuming this is correct for this guitar. This would refer to the neck pickup, and this would refer to the bridge. But in actual fact, they're the other way around. Now, I'm presuming that's because when Dave is playing, and he's usually using the bridge pickup, it's much easier to roll this volume control down than it is to get to this one. Okay, so I'm presuming this is the primary volume control that he's using because most of the riffage that he's playing and lead work will be with the bridge pickup. So that kind of makes sense, but it was confusing at first. And then we've got a master tone control for both pickups, okay? Now, the actual input jack socket is just here, okay? And There's actually two holes on the side if you wanted to put strap buttons on there as well. But by default, there's a knot there, which I'm presuming means that these are for a particular type of strap lock. I could be wrong there, but I'm presuming that's what the case is, because there's no strap buttons external to the guitar, okay? So, very cool guitar, not my personal preference, but that's irrelevant. For Dave Mustaine fans, this, if you've got the money, is an absolute must-have collector item or for Megadeth fans. And they've done a good job of making this very unique. A lot of signature models are just a reissue of a shape, or they've got a different set of pickups in. Gold Leaf and Blood Red, if you're into metal, that's pretty much ticking all the boxes for you if you're a Dave Mustaine or Megadeth fan. So let's have a listen to how it sounds. With this guitar, not a great deal of point demoing clean tones, but we will. Let me just turn this overdrive off. Let me start with the neck pickup. No fancy switching here. Volume control all the way up. So as you can see here, that particular volume control that does all the work, okay? So, high output pickups, this is gonna push the front end of our amp quite hard. Whoops, I went for the wrong volume control again. You can hear that it's kind of pushing and crunching quite hard, but you've got a huge amount of detail in that sound. It's a very, very kind of traditional active pickup sound, but it's a good feel as well. It doesn't feel massively compressed, so it's quite impressive. The pickups certainly are very high-end. You also notice they feature the Dave Mustaine signature on there as well. Okay, so we'll move to the middle position, so both pickups together. So we need both volume controls all the way up. Now, something that's quite nice about having two volume controls is you can blend the different amounts of the pickup in. So if we start again, there's both pickups together. If we roll out the bridge pickup, we get some control over the tone. Now you can see that those are wired in series, so that if I actually roll the volume control of one of those pickups all the way down, we get nothing. But you can do a little bit of blending on there. At this point, let's have a listen to the tone control, so we'll roll it all the way off. And then up again. Okay, and then finally, the bridge pickup, volume all the way up. Okay, so you can hear there that, again, lots of detail, lots of output. This is gonna drive an amp really, really hard. So let's do the same thing now. We'll put the overdrive on and we will have a listen, starting with the bridge pickup. Again, lots of high gain, kind of active pickup sounds. Okay, classic kind of metal tones if you want that scooped kind of vibe. In the middle position, okay, same thing, volume controls all the way up on both pickups. And then finally in the bridge position, in the neck position, I should say, we'll do the same thing. So volume all the way up on that neck pickup. Okay, so not a guitar for everybody, but this certainly works well for Dave Mustaine. It's gonna look great on stage. That gold leaf as well underneath the lights is gonna look particularly spectacular. And if you're a collector and you can find one of these and you've got the money for it, this is gonna retain its value very well indeed, especially with the gold leaf on there. Just very impressive indeed. And also I like the idea that this has actually got a little bit more thought behind it as a signature model than just a reissue or a rehash to kind of make some money, basically. There's a little bit more thought gone into this as well. So kind of cool, absolutely not my kind of guitar at all, but again, totally irrelevant. For Dave Mustaine fans, this is just, as good as it gets, basically. And it's got that USA Dean quality in terms of playability and tone. So, hope you've enjoyed the review, guys. Check out the text in the magazine, and I will see you next time.